Hey guys, what's up? Tim Queen here, and today I'm going to show you how you can create a slideshow for LinkedIn. Now, what's a slideshow? It's a little bit of a trick, but what we are using is we're using the document feature of LinkedIn, and you can upload almost any content type. But what we are looking for is a PDF. Because what the PDF allows us to do is to have the next button, so you can use it as a slideshow, just as PowerPoint or Keynote, and you can go from slide to slide and explore the different content types. And it's a very intuitive form of content that you can use on LinkedIn to educate people, to show content that doesn't fit into the small text post. If you need more than 1,300 characters, this is the content type that you want to do. And today I'm going to show you how you can quickly create a slideshow in Canva, and then how you can use that, and then how you can use that slideshow from Canva and upload it onto your LinkedIn profile. So let's get right into my computer. Now, let me just show you where we would want to post this. So we would at some point click on the homepage and click start a post. And then we would create a document, which we find right over here. And then we would select our PDF document, which contains our entire slideshow. So let's go back and see how we can create this. So first you have to sign up for Canva. I'm going to put the link on the screen so you can quickly find the sign up page for a free account. Then when you have set up your account, you want to open it and you want to locate the top right corner where it says create a design. You want to click on that. And then what you want to select is click on Instagram post. 1080 times 1080 pixel. This will open up a new document. So we do a really simple one. So you could leave it like this and then just add some text. But what we're going to do is we're going to use a little bit of background color. So this is really, really basic. Okay. We just want to select any color. You can pick whatever you want. And then what you want to do is you want to go over here to text. And something I like to do is I like to add a heading. And this is like my main slide. And I'm going to call this placeholder. And then we're going to make this like a lot larger. Something like this. 60 pixel. And as an example, I'm going to just position this over here. What you can then do, this is something what you would put on your slide. And you can have multiple lines of text and whatnot. What I would also do is I would add my logo. I have already created my logo over here. So we're just going to drag this over here. And then we're going to make this like smaller. And we're just going to post this here. So this is a very simple template that we can use. Now, if you're a little bit more creative, you could do all kinds of stuff in Canva. It's not going to be a Canva tutorial, but just to give you some ideas what's possible. And then we can reduce the transparency. And we make sure that this is positioned in front. Okay, great. So let's say this was our template. And then what we would do, we can save this and then duplicate this document. So we always have like a fresh start. So let's do that. So what you can do now that you have like a template slideshow, you can actually go back to the homepage and then you can click on all of your designs. And then you're going to locate this one. This is just generating the thumbnail. And you click over here and you say, make a copy. Now, this will make it really easy when you want to create more slides in the future. So what you want to do now is you want to think about like how many information do you want to share on LinkedIn? Let's say we want to share 3 pages. So you just click this little duplicate icon twice. So now you have 3 pages. And then you can create your content for page one. We may be in tip number one. Let's call this title of presentation. And then it's always good to align this somewhere. Like I like to put this in the center, title of presentation. Then you can share tip one. How to create killer LinkedIn slideshow. There you go. And then we just align this. This is a really simple example. I'm going to show you like a much nicer one, like in a second. So now you have like a 3-page slideshow. And what you then do is you click the download button. And then this is important. You click on file type and you change this, you can either select the PDF standard. Okay, in most cases, so if you want to get a little bit more higher quality, you can do PDF print. And then you're going to click on download. And then it's going to take a little few seconds, and there you have it. If we click this, you can see it's a PDF document with 3 pages. We go back here, click on start a post, then select this icon for documents, then click on choose file, go to your, if you're on a Mac or Windows, find the folder where you have downloaded this. In this case, it's in my download folder. Then you select the file, you click on this, and it will take a few seconds for LinkedIn to process this. And this is how it would look like. It's really important that you add a slide title, how to create a LinkedIn slideshow. I'm obviously not going to post this because this is just a demo, but this is how it would look like. They would be able to flip from left to right and view your document exactly this way. Now that I've shown you how this works, let me show you an actual document. So this one is something I am going to post tomorrow. So if you're lucky, you have already seen this. So in this case, I have a title slide. I'm putting like this little arrow icon to show people that there will be a next button. We have my logo on every slide. We have like the step-by-step process, how you can sign up for Canva. It's a little tutorial, and then people can download this entire thing. So you can see this is really easy and really cool if you can set this up, and then you have like a really long document with over, how many pages did I create? 24 pages. So this will really help you to get people engaged. The more time people spend with a document, the higher your dwell time, meaning you will get more impressions with your content in the LinkedIn content feed. And you can even put in a call to action. For example, in my post, I say, do you want to have more? Get my free LinkedIn hashtag guide. And then I'm including the link how they can download this. I find this is one of the coolest content types on LinkedIn, especially if you are not comfortable on video. You can easily create this yourself in Canva, as you just saw. It really takes just a few minutes. Or if you want to get a little bit of help, you can also go on fiverr.com. I'm going to put the link over here, how you can sign up for that. And you just give them the specs, make a slideshow, Instagram format, and they can set this up in Canva. And you can even send them the link to this tutorial. There are so many great designers on Fiverr. It's really easy. And you can easily convert and repurpose so many different content types. If you have a case study, turn it into a slideshow. If you have a lead magnet, turn it into a slideshow. If you have a cheat sheet, turn it into a slideshow. If you have like 20 tips on one page, just create a 20-page slideshow and you're there. So this is really something I recommend that you check this out. And of course, if you want to get more videos about LinkedIn marketing, also make sure that you hit the subscribe button, turn the notification bell on, and hit the like button. And if you want to dive really deep, learn how to generate leads for your business on LinkedIn, I highly recommend that you check out my LinkedIn Accelerator program. This is my complete A to Z system, how you can generate leads on LinkedIn. So I'm going to put the link down in the description and into the pinned comment below. And I see you next one. Bye.